Hey everyone, I'm so glad that you can join us again today. You see, this week we've got something special. We're going to learn about the best ways that God wanted to teach us how to live, or the people of God. So I want you guys to sit back and enjoy today's lesson, because I think you guys can learn quite a bit, as I learned a bit while teaching and telling you guys the story. The desert is a dangerous place. As we know from our other stories, that not many people go into the desert because there's not much food, there's not much water, and it gets so hot during the day that the sun beats down so hard, and at night it gets so cold. Well, the people of God, they were in the desert with Moses leading the way, showing them where to go and what to do. But they wanted to know what the best way was. What was the best way? I mean, they could do whatever they wanted now. They were free. They could do all sorts of things. But God had the best way to show them. There was a gigantic cloud of smoke that was leading them somewhere. God wanted to meet these people. And so the people followed Moses. They followed the cloud of smoke during the day, and at night they made camp. But as the days went on, they ran out of food, and they started to run out of water. They would complain to Moses, saying that they have led them to their death, some even saying that they are so hungry that they would actually prefer to go back to Egypt, as that's where they thought it might be better to live as slaves. But Moses provided them with the food and the water that they needed with God's help. But they carried on their journey until they saw a gigantic mountain. This they could see was God's mountain, because the whole mountain was engulfed in flames. It was a black mountain, and there was smoke all around it. They could see that something wonderful was here, something incredible. So when they got close, God wanted to meet with his people. But only Moses would go up. He was the only one that was brave enough. Only Moses was brave enough. And he went to the top of the mountain to meet with God. And here he couldn't see face to face with God because, well, we can't really see face to face with God. But there he spoke with God. He could see God's back. And I suppose that's one way for us to be able to know how to follow him. But God gave Moses the 10 best ways to take down to the people of God, to show them the best ways to live. And so Moses took these. He took them and he traveled back down the mountain, and there he gave the 10 best ways to the people. And these 10 best ways, which can be summed up into only 3, which is to love God, to love others, and always know that God loves you. But the 10 best ways that God gave them was: do not serve other gods. Make no idols to worship. Be serious when you say my name. Keep the Sabbath holy. Honor your father and your mother. Do not lie. Don't break your marriage, even though sometimes it can be difficult, and sometimes we have to. Don't want what others have. Do not kill. And the last one is do not steal. These were the 10 best ways that were given to the people of God by God himself. These were the ways to live God wanted to show them what the best ways were. But we always know that we can always love God, and we always know that God loves us, and we should always love others. And so I wonder, well, which of these ways is your favorite? I wonder, which of these ways do you think is the most important one to know, or the most important one to keep? And I wonder, what parts of the story of the people did you like the best?
I hope you guys enjoyed that. And now it's time that we can actually stand up and worship God together. So let's stand up and raise our hands to the sky, and let's dance and sing and jump all together so that we can really praise God and worship God today.
No one like you, none like you.